Shava, come on! Shava, come on! Shava, hurry! Come on! Come on! Shava, hurry! 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 Come on!
Well, I was going to play Resident Evil 5 with Jeff, but this is what ends up happening every time. It's absolutely ludicrous and gives you morbid depression, so I decided instead that I would make a video about Resident Evil 3, because there's something that's been piquing my curiosity, and it's specifically related to Nemesis. Now remember guys, as I always have to give this, because if I don't give this disclaimer, I basically get put up on a cross, burnt alive, you know, stabbed with like 8,000 swords. It's absolutely horrendous. So the disclaimer is, this is just of course a theory. Anything could happen in the final game, but I do believe there's a lot of evidence to suggest this, and I do think if this theory is true, then Capcom's really outdone themselves, and this would be absolutely excellent, and it would really enhance the Resident Evil 3's subplot in a similar way to Lisa Trevor from Resident Evil 1, which is what I've been asking Capcom to do since Resident Evil 2's remake was announced, and they did a really good job fleshing a lot of the things out in that game. For example, Marvin's character went from some random guy that just dies after relaying some information into a fully fleshed character, and I hope that Nemesis actually receives a similar treatment. So without any further delay, let's get into the theory and what I think anyway. Now if you do hear a lot of popping noises more than usual, it's actually rain. There's a hurricane going on in my area, so I do apologize about that. But the theory is, I do believe Capcom has taken very much strong inspirations from the live action Resident Evil movies when it comes to the creation and displaying of Nemesis in the game Resident Evil 3. And a lot of people might be wondering, isn't that a bad thing? Those live actions were all terrible because, you know, that's what everybody says. But I think something that they did really well, to be honest, was actually showing how Nemesis was just a regular person and then was transformed in a lab into this machine of war, a true BOW under control. But then the beautiful part was that he still has some humanity left as well. And of course, this is shown in the original Resident Evil 3 with him saying stars. And that's kind of unique to enemies in this era. They didn't really talk at all. Now, if everyone remembers that scene from Resident Evil 2, Afterlife, I think it was, Nemesis basically saves our main protagonist Alice and just like shoots all the Umbrella security guards around her, like he goes against his orders. I don't think that's obviously going to be changed into Resident Evil 3, I don't think they've taken that much inspiration, but I do think they're going to show how he was just a regular human and kind of make you sympathize with him a little bit more. Now here we have some concept art of Nemesis, and it's kind of interesting because, you know, concept art is usually designed for something that's going to be shown in the game, a trailer or something like that, and we get to see the Umbrella operatives, you know, injecting some wires and plugs into him, and well, you can still see some more humanoid features than you see in the final Nemesis here. However, the thing that is really prominent is the fact that it is shown in the lab. And it's kind of interesting because they didn't really show this in the original Resident Evil 3. And in this concept art, you can see what happens to the scientists in the top left panel. They must have gotten mauled and absolutely destroyed by Nemesis. But it is quite an interesting concept art nonetheless. Now, if you mix it in with this next part from the original trailer for Resident Evil 3, you can see Umbrella not only testing and injecting Nemesis, but also shipping him out on a helicopter ready to be deployed in Raccoon City. Now, this does look very CGI, this cutscene. However, it is possible that something like this, such as in video format, may be able to be found, or maybe it will just be shown in its own little CGI cutscene, because I feel like Resident Evil 3 is going for this blockbuster movie style feeling from everything we've been shown so far. It looks like there'll be much more extensive, lengthy, and also dialogue heavy cutscenes and things like that compared to Resident Evil 2. And it is interesting because although this scene could be just for trailer purposes, they didn't really do anything like that for Resident Evil 2, so I'm not exactly sure. Now, Resident Evil 7 had a lot of scenes, of course, that never made it into the game from the trailers, but They were just like random foresty areas with caterpillars and things. There wasn't really anything relevant to the plot. However, in this Resident Evil 3 trailer, of course, Nemesis is very relevant to the plot. So I really do hope Capcom is going for this approach. We've got the concept art showing him in a lab, we've got him being shipped out and being experimented on, and he's even got a CGI model that, you know, that must have taken a lot of time to work with. It's also his base model without the jacket or anything, like his naked nude body essentially. So yeah, it's pretty interesting, and I really do hope that they do include this. And this is why I was saying I think they might have taken inspiration from the movies, because this is kind of what the movies actually did, and it made you sympathize with Nemesis so much more rather than just feel he's this monster, because it wasn't really his fault. It would be like one of your friends or family being taken by Umbrella and being turned into a mind-controlled B.O.W. You'd just feel bad for them, like regular zombies. But seeing the process would make that kind of an interesting villain so much more than the original game. And again, this is why it would remind me of Lisa Trevor, because although you had to kill her, you still did feel bad about the character and the experiences that the girl had to go through. Anyway, let me know what your thoughts are about this below, guys. Do you think that Resident Evil 3 is going to emulate Resident Evil 1 with some new subplots, some new information, some new narrative cutscenes and things like that? Or do you think it's going to be more like Resident Evil 2, where it changes some things up but sticks true to the original without adding too much in itself? The orphanage being really the only heaviest and newest addition to Resident Evil 2. Let me know what your thoughts are below in the comments. You can support this channel on Patreon. Maybe if, you know, I get $500,000 a month, we'll be able to get rid of this shitty popping microphone. You can also follow me on Twitter and all the other relevant things. All the links are, of course, in the description below. But I just hope for now, guys, you're having a beautiful day. As always, take it easy and peace.